Page 26, Estrellita, or little star. The top of the page on 26, they have a little box there talking about an encore. An encore, well, you can think, I don't want to read that. You can read all about it. It's just something you play at the end when, just a fun little thing people enjoy hearing. Of course, when professional pianists, these touring pianists do encores, they're usually main pieces. They're huge, many of them. I don't know about being an encore. To me, this is a recital piece. This is what you play in a recital, or to play for someone if they wanted to hear something nice. It's a really sweet piece if you're into this really sweet music. You're going to love this. Let's talk about it, because a few things I want to point out here. I'm going to start with the right hand. You have a two-beat pickup, because it's in 4-4 time. So it starts on beat 3. So it's 3-4-1. Follow their fingering, it's fine. For the most part, then 4, and then come under for the 1. You should be able to connect these with the fingers, in my opinion. I know the pedal's down, but try and do it with the fingers and get the rhythm. In the first full measure, it's 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 1, 2, 3. You reach down for the last note in the first line to the G. It's a bit of a stretch, but you can reach it. It's doable. And second line there. I don't like using the same finger on repeated notes. I'm not going to say anything right now because there's enough in here to point out. So I'm going to leave that alone. But the second measure, watch the fingering. It's a 2-1 for the F sharp G. And this is a B flat. This is in the key of F major. Do the F major scale, know it. So it's a B flat. Going on, the last two measures of the second line is a 5-4. You reach down for the last note to a C. That's a stretch. If you can't reach it, the pedal will help connect it, so you may have to move down. Another way you can do it, or if you think about it, is that last measure, you have a 4 on the D. You could play the C with a 4th finger. If you want a 2, and that makes this last note a little closer. But again, if it doesn't help, then you just have to reach down. And then the third line is similar to what you already played. Fourth line, we have the 8th notes. So you have a rest on beat 1. Rest and 2. Second measure in the last line. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. That ends that. Top of page 27. Rest on the first beat. Rest. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Watch the fingering. It's 2-1. Otherwise, it's pretty straightforward here. To the last measure of the first line, you crunch up a little bit and put the 4th finger on the A. And then down. And then 4th finger on the B flat in the second line, first measure. And then 2-1 again. And then 4th finger on the B flat. We do the 4th finger on the B flat there because it's in position for here. We want it this position. And so that's what it is. And then the 3rd line down. You're going to lift the hand up. It's between phrases, so you're going to lift the hand up and back down. That gives you, to move the hand like that, lets you split the phrases. And then it's like at the beginning, and et cetera, for the rest of it. In the left hand, let's look at this fingering. Over on top of page 26, when the left hand plays, you're here. And then another 5th finger. So it's 1 and 2 and 3. So you're using 5th finger for both of those, but that's very common. So that's okay. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3. 4 and 1 and 2 and 3, 4 and 1 and rest, etc. That's pretty much the rhythm throughout most of this for the left hand. You're just, you know, you're moving around quite a bit, and yes, you'll probably have to look down for it. Eventually, you'll develop a feel for those distances, but, you know, glance down. You're only glancing down. You don't have to look down and study the keyboard. Hopefully, you know what a keyboard looks like by now. You're just glancing down to see at the beginning here, the F, just glance down to see where that C is, and then right back up, because your mind, your brain will retain that image for a little bit. It's the same as looking at it. So just, then you're fine pretty much until you get to the end, at the bottom of page 27, the last couple of measures or whatever. When the right hand is playing that whole note F at the end, then the left hand is here. Then you gotta come down with the thumb for that last quarter note. Pedal connects it all, and this is fine. It's good fingering. Now at the beginning of this, it says andante, which is just a nice, comfortable, leisurely pace. Don't rush it. It's okay. They give a metronome marking, whatever. But what do you think andante feels like? You have to... I mean, one day you'll feel at one speed, and another day you'll feel at another speed. I just don't get locked on one speed. Just, it's andante. There's a range. They give you a range there on the metronome, so whatever. Then, dynamics, it starts out MP. It says con espressione. I can't speak Italian with a Kansan accent, but there you go. It simply means with expression. Well, you gotta learn it first. So you get all the mechanics out of the way, and then once you can play all the notes and the pedaling and everything is there, then you start feeling it. All music is with expression. So, yeah, feel it. So, you do the cone expression thing. Let's talk about this medium soft. What's that? I don't know. It's somewhere between soft and medium loud, so whatever. And that's the melody. The left hand has to stay under it. Left hand is staying pretty soft throughout the whole thing, so. And you can grow as you want. If you feel that getting a little louder there, it's okay. You can come up and down. You don't have to stay right at medium soft. That's not with expression. You feel it. And if you feel like it's going to get a little louder, then let it get a little louder. If you feel like it should get a little softer, then let it get a little softer. These dynamics they're giving are just guides as to where you are at that point in time, because they don't give you very much. They don't give you any crescendos or decrescendos or nothing. So you kind of got to feel them and add them in. It's called interpreting the music. Now over on page 27 at the top, this is mezzo forte. They're telling you this part is a little louder. So here, not a lot louder, just... Now it's very soft. Now you're going back up to medium loud. Like, yeah, this is like the climax of the piece, if there is one, that A. Then you can come down. Then get softer and die away. They don't give you any of that. You have to interpret all of that in there when you think it. By the way, careful, because at the top of page 26, the first line between the first full measure and the second, you see this, the eighth notes? It goes to a G. And it does that in a few places, but then you go two lines down, same place between the second and third measure, your eighth notes, goes to an A. So they're not always going to the same note. Watch out. Pedal-wise, I've got some suggestions for the pedal, too. They're giving you slightly more variations in pedaling here. You're not pedaling at all. You're still pedaling a lot of it, legato pedaling, but I would still like to make some suggestions. I'm going to challenge you a little more. Again, if you're struggling, then forget this. Just pedal it the way they're showing you, but I'd like to point out some things. At the beginning, when the pedal comes in, I'm going to play the notes in the measure and then push the pedal down. And they're pedaling it, on a lot of these, they're pedaling it every two beats. Not everything. Sometimes it's the whole measure, but in this measure, on the third beat, I'm going to change the pedal. I'm going to lift it up and put it down after I play the notes. So it's this. Right there on the last measure of the first line, the pedal is changed on the third beat. First measure, the second line. Lift the pedal up right before you play the notes in the right hand, so there's silence. To play the last measure of the first line and the first measure of the second line, it's this. You hear the silence? Put the pedal down right after you play the first D, so the D's are connected. First measure of the third line. Here's, I like to separate the phrases. So we're in the right hand, we're the A, half note A, is ending a phrase. You see the phrase mark coming from nowhere, it's from the previous line. And then the C starts a new phrase, and I'm going to lift up and down, so there's silence. Well, I'm going to lift the pedal up with the right hand, so I get silence. The left hand stays down, but I want silence in the right hand, so it's here. Put the pedal down right after I play these notes, the third beat. So very slowly, that measure is here. I lift the pedal up with the right hand and then play the next ones and then put the pedal down. Like so, so it's here. And I hear a little break in the phrases, so I'm separating the phrases. This is a little tricky. Going on. Last line, first measure, is similar to the second line, first measure. I want to lift the pedal up right before I play the eighth notes. So it's here. Because it's a new phrase. Now, I would lift the pedal up right after I play the first note. In the first measure, at the top of page 27, in the left hand, you play this. Right after I play that, I lift the pedal up. I don't need the pedal for the rest of the measure, because I want silence before I play, because it's a new phrase. So I'm going to start with the last measure of page 26, going on. It's this way. Because I'm lifting the right hand. Basically, I'm lifting the pedal up with the right hand, is what I'm doing. So here. First measure of the second line on page 27. Again, I'm going to lift the pedal up with the right hand. I want silence between the C and the B flat. It's a new phrase. Here. Like so. So it's this way. So the B flat's by itself. Now they're showing a two note slur. I don't know if I really like that. I think I would prefer to slur that all together. So the last note of the first measure in the second line on page 27, I would connect that on like it's all slurred together. I don't know why they're splitting that. To me, that's a little choppy. So, and the pedal's covering it up anyway, so I would blend it all together, connect it. And then on the first measure, the third line, again, lift the pedal up, this time with both hands, so we get just a little silence before you go on. So it's this way. Two. The end, the pedal, and the hands all come up at the same time. That's my recommendation. This is a wonderful piece to play for people if they want to hear you play. Let's go over this really, really slowly to double check the notes and the rhythms and all that stuff. 4-4 time, I'm going to give a 6 counts, a full 4 counts plus 2, and then we'll come in. So put your hands where they go. Here. Foot on the pedal. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, ready, go.